Well, the Edmonton Oilers get shut out by the New York Rangers tonight here at Rogers Place on a night where try they may, but there wasn't too many offensive opportunities for the Oilers.
No, not a lot, and not enough. There were some, I thought, in the third period, but as you know, as the game started, certainly not a lot there. A little bit in the second, a little bit more in the third, but by then you're playing catch up. And you know, part of it, I'll give credit to the New York Rangers for not giving the Oilers much, but for Edmonton, and I know Jay Woodcroft talked about it after the game, that there weren't second chances or third chances, and you've really got to work hard to get to the front of that net. And he felt that they didn't work hard enough to generate those types of chances. So, you know, they played a team, a very good team, very good New York Ranger team, now 5-2 on the season, and deservedly so, because they came in, they played well, and Edmonton was, unfortunately, the second-best team on the ice.
It seems like game after game so far through these first few, we credit the goaltending, and the numbers may not show it, but it's because the goaltending really has been good and stand out, and that's exactly what Stuart Skinner and David again tonight.
Well, he gave the Oilers a chance. He absolutely did. I thought, you know, through 40 minutes, the Oilers were down 3-0. That could have been 6-0.
Yeah.
And there was a couple of posts in there too in the second period by the Rangers, but you know, Stuart Skinner gave the Oilers a quality start, and he made some, you know, exceptional saves. I think of that one coming across in the first period, that was a really big stop. He made some, you know, throughout the game. Certainly in the second period, there were some really big ones. So I thought he gave his team an opportunity. That's all you can ask from your goalie.
Yeah.
He can't create the offense, and he's not going to score goals, but he held him in and gave him a chance. That's good to see for Stuart. He'd love to have the win, you know, for the team, but I thought he did all that he could do. And you know, even that shot by Braden Schneider, it looked like Schneider did a great job of changing the angle to get it by Darnell Nurse, and it may have caught a piece of Darnell Nurse. I'd have to see it again to know, but he used Nurse as a screen, then changed the angle and shot it. So I got to give the guy credit.
And you already said it, this is a very good Rangers team, so you got to give them credit because they worked their caliber tonight.
They did. It started in goal. Jonathan Quick was outstanding. He gets the shutout. That's his 59th of his career, his first of the season, his fourth against the Oilers in his career. So, you know, he was good, but he didn't have to deal with a lot of quality opportunities. And I credit the entire Ranger team, but certainly their six defensemen were incredibly noticeable in how easy they were able to get control of the puck in their own end and then get it going the right direction out of their own end. I mean, Adam Fox is an elite defenseman in the National Hockey League. He showed that tonight. But the other five all played incredibly well. So some credit has to be given to the opposition when they play as well as they did. And I thought offensively they generated opportunities throughout all four of their lines. But it started in goal with Jonathan Quick.
Well, tonight was the first night of a very big weekend here in Oil Country. Of course, we got the Heritage Classic on Sunday in Oil Country. We cannot wait to see you there.